Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atiq. I welcome all of you to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Today I am going to discuss one more important concept of our Python, that is tuples. Okay, in my previous video already I have discussed about dictionaries in Python. Okay, by using dictionary we can store different types of items in the form of key and value relationship. Now, what is the use of tuples? By using a tuple, we can able to store different types of items in our Python program. Sir, how it is possible, sir? How, what is the syntax of creating a tuple? How we can create a tuple and how we can store the elements inside the tuple and how we can display those contents? Each and everything I am going to show you in my today's video. Dear students, a tuple is represented with the help of parentheses. So, if a parenthesis is available, then you need to know that it is a tuple. We know that a list is represented with the help of brackets. Next, dictionary is represented with the help of opening and closing brace. So, we should know the difference between these three. So, whenever we are using parenthesis, it is a tuple. Whenever we are using a bracket, then it is a list. And whenever we are using opening and closing braces, this is a dictionary. Okay, so in all these three types of concepts, different types of items will be stored. But what is the difference between them, you will come to know later. But let me concentrate on how to create a tuple first. Okay, a tuple can be created by using a parenthesis symbol. Already I have told you. Let me write one small Python program to create and display the tuple now. So, I am taking a variable which is used to represent the tuple, which is t. T is equal to parenthesis open. Now, here I am giving the value 5. That is the first item I have stored in my tuple. Next, second value I am going to store as a string, which is Python. And next I am going to store one more value, which is a fractional part, 2.5. You can see here three types of items I have stored or I have assigned in my tuple. What are those different types of items? One is an integer, one is a string, another one is a floating point number. So these three items are different items. These three items I have stored in my tuple, which is represented by t, small t. Now I want to display this tuple on the screen. In order to display this entire tuple, what I am going to do, I can make use of the function print of t. So what I will get the expected output when we execute this program, the expected output will be the tuple, that is 5 comma python comma next 2.5. This is the expected output, tuple can be displayed. Now next thing. Sir, can we access the individual items of a tuple and can be displayed on the screen? Yes, of course it is possible. So let me take you to one more example program now. So here what I am going to do in this second example program, let us take a variable which represents the tuple, t assignment operator, that is equal to same 5 comma python comma here 2.5. Now, I want to display the contents of this tuple individually now. Can I access those contents of my tuple? Yes, it is possible. So, what I am going to do, I will make use of the function print. Now, I want to display the first value of my tuple. So, t of 0. So, the first value of the tuple will be stored at the index 0. So, I have used t of 0. I want to display the second value of my tuple. So what I am going to do, print t of 1. Next I want to display the third value of my tuple. Next one more print function, print of t of 2. Okay, now when I execute this program, what is the expected output we will get in this? The expected output will be, first line we will get the answer 5, next line we will get the answer python, and the third line we will get the answer 2.5. So this is the output we will get. So we can easily access the contents of the entire tuple. The only thing we need to remember is in tuple the first element starts with the index 0. Unlike in dictionaries where the value can be accessed with the help of key, here we are, there are no keys in either tuples or even in list, we need to access their contents by using the starting index 0. My dear student, this is very very important point, 0 1 2. So we need to make use of the index, always the index will start from 0. And one more important thing is the contents of the tuples cannot be changed. This is the major difference between the list and tuples. In list we can able to change the contents, whereas in tuples once you store the values, if you want to change the values then the values cannot be changed. Tuples are fixed set of items, whereas dictionaries are changeable items in which you can change the items whenever you want. Okay, now you can see here I have used the index 0 to start to display the first element, 1 to display the second element, and 2 to display the third element. If there is fourth element, then I can make use of T of 3 to display the fourth element inside my tuple. Okay, so the question of my today's video is, can we change the contents of a tuple? Whether it is possible to change the contents of the tuple, whether the answer is yes or not, simply put it in the comment section. So with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.